Hello students, so we have been discussing chapter 11, alcohol, phenol and ether. Okay, in last lecture we had discussed about physical properties of alcohol and phenol. Today we are going to start new topic, that is chemical properties. So chemical properties of alcohol and phenol. Okay, now let me tell you one thing. Alcohol can act as nucleophile as well as electrophile. Alcohol can act as nucleophile as well as electrophile. Let us understand this. So in first case, alcohol can act as nucleophile. Okay. So in which case alcohol can act as nucleophile? For example, we have got alcohol. So this is alcohol, ROH. This is alcohol. Now, we have got carbocation. So this is carbocation. Now in this case, this lone pair of electron of alcohol can attack on carbon which is having positive charge. So because of this, the product will be like this. And because of this, this bond of H is broken. So here, this bond is broken. So it will look like this. Here, O minus and H plus is there. And here, carbon is there. Okay. It will look like this. So this H plus will be released. So because of this breakage of bond between O and H, H plus is released. So here in this case, alcohol is acting as nucleophile. Alcohol can act as nucleophile. Now whenever alcohol is acting as a nucleophile, the bond between oxygen hydrogen is broken. Remember this. Now in second case, alcohol can act as electrophile. Okay. Now whenever alcohol can act as electrophile, alcohol should be protonated, which means proton should be added in alcohol. So suppose this is alcohol. Now proton is added, so it will look like this, ROH2. Okay, so this is protonated alcohol. Now whenever there is reaction of alcohol as an electrophile, alcohol should be in protonated form. It should be in protonated form, which means it should have extra proton. Okay, now in this case, suppose this is Br minus or any halogen, right? This is protonated alcohol. Now this protonated alcohol will be released and this bond is broken. Bond between alkyl and oxygen is broken. So, and Br minus will attack on alkyl group. So it will form like this, RBr plus H2O. So the bond between carbon or alkyl group and oxygen is broken, and this negative group will attack on alkyl group and it will form bond with alkyl group, and this OS2 or H2O is released. So whenever protonated alcohol is acting as electrophile, the bond between carbon and oxygen is broken. So for the chemical properties, there are two types of properties, in which first property is in which bond between oxygen and hydrogen is broken. Second property is bond between carbon and oxygen is broken. Again, I am repeating this thing. Chemical properties of alcohol are of two types. First property, that is based on breakage of bond between oxygen and hydrogen. So first property is based on breaking of oxygen and hydrogen bond, and second property is based on breaking of carbon and oxygen bond. So there are two types of properties. We'll discuss first type of property today. We'll discuss properties based on breaking of oxygen and hydrogen bond. Okay. So today we are going to discuss properties based on OH bond, breaking of OH bond. Okay. So first, reactions involve breaking of OH bond. So today we are going to discuss the reactions in which OH bond is broken. Like this. This is alcohol. Okay, this bond is going to be broken in chemical reactions that we are going to discuss today. Okay, so first chemical reaction based on breaking of hydrogen OH bond is acidity. So topic is acidity of alcohol. Okay, now the question is, why alcohol is acidic in nature? What compound or which compound should be acidic? So those compounds which can donate protons easily are acidic, or we can say that those compound which has got capacity to donate protons, they can act as acid. So here we are talking about acidity of alcohol, which means alcohol should have property to donate proton, or we can say that alcohol is donating proton. So when alcohol is donating proton, it can act as an acid. Now, which are the chemical reactions in which alcohol can donate protons? So chemical reactions are reaction with metals, reaction with metals. So whenever there is reaction between alcohol and metal, specially or specifically active metals like sodium, potassium or aluminium, alcohol act as an acid. Let's understand this by one example. So we have got alcohol ROH. Okay, we have taken 2 moles of alcohol. It reacts with 2 moles of sodium. Okay, now we are talking about breaking of OH bond. So this bond is broken. Now whenever there is breaking of this bond, hydrogen is removed, or we can say that proton is getting released. So here this bond is broken, so hydrogen is released. So 2 moles of alcohol is there, so it will form H2. One hydrogen and one hydrogen, H2 is released. Now what is left? So here RO minus is left, that is known as alkoxide. Okay, this is alkoxide and 2 moles of alkoxide is there. Here metal is there, and metal, as we know, it is having positive charge, so it will combine with alkoxide, so it will form sodium alkoxide. So this is sodium alkoxide. Sodium alkoxide. Okay. So we can say that whenever alcohol reacts with any active metal like sodium, bond between oxygen and hydrogen is broken, and hydrogen is released. Now what is left? Alkoxide is left. Alkoxide can react with metal and it will form metal alkoxide. So this is sodium alkoxide. Let's understand this by one example. We have got 2 moles of phenol. So this is phenol. It reacts with sodium. So as we know, the bond between hydrogen and oxygen is broken. So this bond is broken. And we have got 2 moles of phenol, so H2 is released. So hydrogen is of 2 moles, so it will be released in the form of H2. Now what is left? So we have got phenoxide. So this is phenoxide. Phenoxide can react with sodium because sodium has got positive charge, so it will form sodium phenoxide. So this is sodium phenoxide. Sodium phenoxide. So sodium phenoxide is formed. Okay. So phenol reacts with sodium. Bond between oxygen and hydrogen is broken, and it will form H2. So hydrogen is formed. And what is left? Phenoxide is left. Oxygen on the benzene ring, oxygen minus charge on the benzene ring is known as phenoxide. So phenoxide reacts with sodium and it will form sodium phenoxide. Okay. So this reaction shows that whenever alcohol reacts with any metal, it will form alkoxide or phenoxide and it will release hydrogen. So in every case, hydrogen is released. Now let us understand this by one more example. So we have got tertiary alcohol, CH3CCH3CH3OH. So this is tertiary alcohol. As you can see that OH containing carbon is attached with three carbons, that is known as tertiary, right? So this is tertiary alcohol. We have taken 6 moles. It reacts with 2 moles of aluminium. Now as we know, the bond between oxygen and hydrogen is broken. This bond is broken. So it will form, see, 6 hydrogens are released. So it will be released in the form of 3H2. Okay. So first product is, this bond is broken. So hydrogens are released. 6 hydrogens are released. So 6 hydrogen can form 3 moles of H2. Now what is left? So we have got alkoxide, tertiary alkoxide. This is tertiary butoxide. We can say that tertiary butoxide. 6 moles of tertiary butoxide and we have got 2 moles of aluminium. So because it is having minus 1 charge and aluminium has got plus 3 charge, so it will form like this. So here, this butoxide will form one like this. Okay, so 3 moles of 2, 3 are 6 moles of butoxide is there. It will combine with 2 moles of aluminium. So this is final product. This is known as aluminium tertiary butoxide. Aluminium tertiary butoxide. So why have we have written 2 moles? Because 2 moles of aluminium can react with 6 moles of butoxide and it will form 2, 3 are 6 moles of butoxide and 2 moles of aluminium. So aluminium reacts with butoxide and it will form aluminium tertiary butoxide. Okay. Now, all these reactions suggest that alcohol reacts with metal and it will form alkoxide, or alcohol or phenol can react with metal and it will form phenoxide. So these all reactions suggest that alcohol is releasing H plus, because bond between O and H is broken, so H plus is released. So whenever any compound donates H plus or release H plus, it is acting as an acid. So we can say that alcohol are acting as an acid. So these all reactions suggest that alcohol are acidic in nature. Let's see one more example. So we have got phenol. Okay, so this is phenol. Phenol reacts with NaOH, sodium hydroxide, and as we know, this bond is broken. So H plus from phenol, OH minus from NaOH, it will form H2O. So H2O is formed. Now what is left? Phenoxide is left and sodium is left. So it will form sodium phenoxide. So sodium phenoxide is formed. So phenol reacts with base and it will form sodium phenoxide. This reaction also just suggests that because alcohol or phenol can react with base, NaOH is a strong base, so phenol must be acidic in nature, and because of this it can react with base. Because phenol can react with base, so it suggests that phenol is an acid phenol is acidic in nature. Okay, so these all reactions suggest that alcohol and phenol can act as an acid, or they are acidic in nature. Okay, so we have discussed till now alcohol is acidic in nature. Specifically, we can say that alcohol is a Bronsted acid. Now, what is Bronsted acid that we have studied in standard 11? Bronsted acid is an acid which can donate H plus, right? Those acids or those compounds which can donate H plus are known as Bronsted acid. So, alcohol is a Bronsted acid. Let's understand this by one example. So, we have got base. This is base. Alcohol, we are writing like this. This is alcohol. Okay. Now, as we know, this H plus is donated by this alcohol. This is alcohol. And bond between O and H is broken. So, this H plus of alcohol is donated by alcohol to base, and it will form product like this. So, this is conjugated acid. Conjugated acid. Now, what is left? So, this bond is broken. So, RO minus is left. So, alkoxide is left. And it can act as conjugated base. So, this reaction suggests that alcohol is donating H plus 2 base. And whenever in any reaction, any compound donates H plus, this compound is Bronsted acid. So, in this case, alcohol is donating H plus 2 base and it is forming conjugated acid, conjugated base. So, since alcohol can donate H plus, we can say that alcohol is Bronsted acid. So, alcohol is Bronsted acid. Now, primary, secondary and tertiary alcohol, if we were asked to define the order of acidity in case of primary, secondary and tertiary alcohol, which order would be there? So, we can write, so this is primary alcohol, RCH2OH, CHOH, this is secondary alcohol, RCOH. This is tertiary alcohol. This is primary alcohol. This is secondary alcohol. And this is tertiary alcohol. Now, we have been asked to arrange this primary, secondary, tertiary alcohol in acidic order, increasing or decreasing acidic order. So, which is stronger acid? Primary, secondary, or tertiary? And why? Now, the acidity of this alcohol, let's say this is alcohol. The acidity of this alcohol is because of its polar nature. Oxygen is having negative charge, so it will have minus delta because it is having higher electronegativity. Hydrogen will have positive charge. So, alcohol has got polar nature. It is polar in nature. And because of this polar nature, it is a Bronsted acid, or it is an acid. You can say that. Now, as we have known, as we already know that because of polar nature of alcohol, it is acidic in nature. Now, one alkyl group is there, two alkyl groups are there, and three alkyl groups are there. Okay. Now, alkyl group is electron donating group, so it can donate electron. Alkyl group can donate electrons. Now, because of this electron donating nature of alkyl group, the polarity of OH bond decreases. So, this polarity decreases. And as polarity decreases, the acidic nature decreases because it has got less tendency to donate H+. So, the acidic strength will look like this. Again, acidity of alcohol is because of polar nature of this OH group, right? As we know, polar nature means this is minus charge, this is plus charge, and because of minus plus charge, it is polar in nature. Now, alkyl group has tendency to donate electrons, so it can donate electrons. Because of donating nature of this alkyl group, oxygen will have more electron density. So here more electron density there. So more alkyl group, more electron density is there. And because of more electron density, it will have less polarity. And because of less polarity, it can have less acidity. Okay. So more polarity, more acidity, less polarity, less acidity. And polarity is affected by alkyl group. More alkyl group. So we are discussing acidity of alcohol and water. So we are saying that water is more acidic than alcohol. Please remember this statement for short question answer. If we are asked to compare acidity of water and alcohol, we can say that water is more acidic than alcohol. Let us understand this by one example. So we have got a base. Alkoxide is a base. This is water. It is acting as an acid, right? So water is donating H plus to base. So this alkoxide is gaining H plus and it is forming alcohol. That is conjugate acid. Now since H plus is donated from this water, it will form OH minus, which is conjugate base. So here, water has got more tendency to donate H plus. Water has got more tendency to donate H plus. Since it can donate H plus easily, it is more acidic in nature. So water is more acidic in nature compared to alcohol. And here also, alkoxide is accepting or gaining H plus. So since alkoxide can gain H plus or can accept H plus easily, it is a stronger base. So there is comparison between alcohol and water. So alcohol is less acidic, water is more acidic. If there is comparison between alkoxide and sodium hydroxide with respect to base, if there is comparison between this alkoxide and sodium hydroxide, we can say that alkoxide is a stronger base. So compared to alcohol and water, water is a stronger acid, whereas alkoxide and sodium hydroxide, when we compare basic nature of alkoxide and sodium hydroxide, we can say that alkoxide is a stronger base. Okay. Now, alcohol has got dual property. Alcohol can donate H plus and it can act as bronsted acid. And since alcohol has also got, see, this is structure of alcohol, right? Alcohol has got lone pair of electrons, so it can accept H plus and it can act as bronsted base. Okay. So alcohol can donate H plus and it can act as an acid, whereas alcohol can also gain or accept H plus because it has got lone pair of electron. So it can accept H plus and it can act as bronsted base. So we can say that alcohol act as an bronsted acid or alcohol act as an bronsted base. Okay.